Hey everybody, it is Liberty Whispers, and today we're going to be playing some Sims 4. I know that there are a few people who enjoy ASMR slash softly spoken slash relaxing let's plays of Sims games. And I am quite partial to playing this game too. It's been a little while since I've played for any amount of time. I want to say about 6 months, maybe a little less, I don't know. It's certainly been a while since I did any Sims-based content on this channel. In fact, I think last time I did a Sims video, we made the same character that we're about to play with. Pretty sure it's the same guy, but it has admittedly been a while, so who knows. Anyway, we're going to be playing with this guy. He is called Emre Conner, and we moved him into this apartment, Culpeper Apartments, primarily because it was affordable and also because it's supposedly haunted, so I figured that would make for an interesting game playing experience, I guess. So we're gonna jump into his apartment. I'm gonna give you a quick tour. Alright. So, oh yeah, when I logged in the game, Emre's occupation was a barista, but I wanted to give him a new sort of career path, and so looking at his, traits, wherever they are, one of them was kleptomaniac. And I kind of do remember picking that when we made him. So I looked at that, and I looked at his other sort of traits. Geek, alluring, cheerful. And I decided to send him on the criminal career path. Because I figured he could be kind of charming and suave and sort of schmooze his way into a life of crime. Plus, who doesn't like a good villain, right? And with that mustache right there, he is prime villain material. So, we've switched careers. We are currently working, as you can see there, as a tough guy, and getting paid a pretty measly $9 an hour. But hopefully we are going to advance in our chosen career. As you can see, living up to his reputation as a tough guy with his bunny rabbit slippers. He is uncomfortable by all accounts. He needs food. But before we get him fixed up with some food, we are going to take a quick look around his apartment. Actually, okay, I was going to say, let's see when he's meant to start work. It's meant to start work in 9 hours at 5 p.m. Unconventional hours, but hey, I guess it is a unconventional career choice. Okay, so you're gonna have to bear with me a little bit because I am kind of getting used to the keyboard shortcuts. Again, I don't know most of them. It's something I should probably try and read upon for the next set of videos. That is, of course, if you guys want to see more of this. Hopefully you do. Because, as I said, I enjoy playing this game. And I figured if you guys enjoy it, we could kind of keep it continuous. Maybe, you know, have some leaps in time. Maybe not make it chronological, but could sort of dip in and out and see how Emre's doing. Alright, so we're going to start with the master bedroom, which is kind of bare bones. We have this this bed there, which looks quite nice. And we have a set of dresser drawers. And that really is pretty much it for the bedroom. I think I had about 14,000 simoleons to spend. I wanted to keep some to make sure we had money for rent. Which, you know, is kind of important. I decorated most of it with hardwood floor and sort of red brick walls. Kind of runs throughout. Obviously, that will change in the bathroom, which we'll get to in a minute, but it's kind of what I wanted to go for. I may actually change the floor, because looking at it again, I'm not too keen on it, to be honest. But I do like the red brick interior. As you can see in the living room, we have a bookshelf, which is important. We don't have a TV at the minute, because as I said, I wanted to kind of keep a little bit of cash for rent and living expenses and such, but we do have this quite nice coffee table and what looks like a pretty comfy sofa. This over here is a historic plaque, which we cannot actually move. That is one of the conditions with this apartment. It's probably why it's haunted, because there's something probably supernatural about that. Just read the plaque, and we'll get Emery to go and have a quick look at that. But yeah, that is there. And at first, I wasn't too keen on it, but it's kind of different and kind of gives the apartment a bit of character, I guess. Okay, I did not mean to zoom out that far. Okay. And yet, I'm still zooming out. There we go, that's a little bit better. Yeah. Like I said, I am still kind of getting used to working my way around to do things, but yeah, I mean, so far the apartment is pretty scarce, but I quite like the fact it's small, yet sort of large enough to not feel claustrophobic. One of the just the general things that would stick with me whenever playing The Sims would be that I would usually make sort of duplexes rather than multi-storied houses, and I would always try and kind of keep the amount of rooms to a pretty reasonable level, mainly for practical reasons, because otherwise I was constantly looking for people and it just, I don't know, didn't feel too manageable if the building was too big. So as you can see, we've got our fridge there, which we're going to open in just a minute. In fact, let's do that. What we're going to have, what time is it? It is 8:42 in-game time. So let's have some breakfast, and let's do eggs and toast. And let's get into play mode. We also have our oven over in the corner. We've got our countertops, a microwave, and a sink, with some sort of cabinets overhead. It's a pretty nice and simple layout. I like it. It's not fussy. It's not flashy. It's practical. And it looks, you know, my AI is pretty good. Oh no. A fire is not relaxing at all. Let's try and contain this. Oh, please don't die, Emery. Okay. Let's move over there. Let's get over there, buddy. I'm going to be really annoyed if he catches fire. Emery, just move. Oh my goodness. Let's speed up time. Why isn't he moving? Why are you not moving? Oh, he is actually on fire. Wow, this is not going well. Emery, just, oh no, why isn't he moving? Just, oh, can I put myself out? Extinguish self. Okay, do that, do that. Emery, say. Wow. This. Wow, that was a. That was a close call. I guess I should have maybe read a cookbook first. I don't know. That is not what I was expecting whatsoever. Yeah, you better go take a shower, Emery. Yikes. Well, it's an interesting way to begin, I guess. Okay. I think, have we got people? Yeah, we've got people coming around to see us. This is. This is not a great time, guys. You know, I appreciate the gesture, but I've just set myself on fire. I think I've destroyed my oven. Yeah, there you go. If only life was that easy, right? You'd burn something and you should click on it and replace it. Yeah, that was a close call. Yeah, our time with Emery was nearly cut very short. Alright, so maybe we just call for a pizza. It's maybe the best way to go. Well, he is still just like covered in smoke and soot. Talk about making a first impression. Alright, here we go. I guess these are our neighbours in the surrounding apartments. Oh, Emery, I wouldn't go for the eggs and toast again, I tell you what. Let's call for a pizza. How do we do that? Is it hire a service? I don't know. Yeah, there you go, pizza delivery. Perfect. Let's go with just cheese. Everyone loves a cheese pizza, right? Okay. So let's take a look at who our neighbours are. We have got Arun Bida. We've got Gita Rasoya. We've got Raj Rasoya. And we've got Yasminda Bida. And I really don't have much in the way of entertainment for them. Unfortunately. He's still trying to make egg and toast. Let's just put it away. Oh, do you know something? I just realised I didn't actually buy a trash can or rubbish bin. So let's do that now. Because otherwise we will have nowhere to put our ruined eggs and toast. Okay. Do we want that in here? It looks kind of cool, but is it gonna seem out of place? I mean, at some point I would like just like a rubbish disposal unit, if there is such a thing. But does that? Yeah, that looks. That does not look good. Let's just go with a standard bin. Actually, do you know something? Let's see if we can stretch. I didn't actually want to do build mode. Let's see if we can stretch to at least something with music for our guests. Like a boombox or something. Yeah. Let's go with that for the time being. It's something, right? Let's have some pop. Why not? And let's go back into live mode. Okay, the man's here. Hey, Yuji. Good to see you. Yeah, I cannot believe I set myself on fire. As in, like, one of the first things I've done. Yeah, we should probably just at least skim a cookery book. So that doesn't happen again. Okay, let's grab a slice. Let's speed up time a touch. Yeah, Emre is very tense. I mean, I guess setting yourself on fire and then having to extinguish yourself will kind of do that to you. Make you feel just a little bit tense. You still just... I thought he was just staring at the pizza for a second. Oh well, everyone seems to be having a pretty good time. I mean, the music has definitely helped. I have muted the sound, by the way. Just because I think it makes for a more relaxing experience for you guys. But if there is a sort of overwhelming demand for at least a little bit of in-game sound effects, then I will certainly switch it back on and set it to a low level. But unless there is an outpouring of people that really care about having the sound from the game, and hold on, who is Catherine Crumb? She wants to come over to hang out. Okay, let's see where this goes. I can't remember if we met Catherine in the initial video. But she seems to know Emre, so let's see where this goes. Who knows, maybe it might lead to some romance. Although, given the fact that Emre looks like burnt leftovers, I'm not holding out too much hope. Okay. So, yep, she's just obviously very comfortable with Emre. She just walked straight in. Doesn't seem to care that there's four strangers in the room. Let's get to know our neighbor a little bit. She has just... Where has she gone? Oh, she has just gone to... Well, it's gone to read a book on Emre's bed. A little bit antisocial of Catherine. Just leaving the party and just going to read a book by herself, but hey, maybe she is not too comfortable around strangers. I don't know. Let's have a look actually. What relationship do they have? So they are just currently acquaintances. She is unemployed. She is a foodie. And that's about all we know of Catherine. Oh, this fella is he leaving? Or is he just saying it was nice to chat? Well, it was nice to chat with you too, Raj. Oh, okay, apparently we have some bad relationships with these people. Travis Scott, Summer Holiday, and Elliot Crumb. Cannot say I remember any of these people. Let's go check in on Catherine, because it looks like these guys are about to go. But it was very nice of them to come and welcome me to the building. Let's go get to know Catherine. We didn't really get to know much about our guests. Oh, Catherine's just leaving. Yeah, Emre, you look a bit of a state fella, not gonna lie. Okay, Emre has learned the following traits about Catherine. She is a slob. Well, you know, not exactly something that I myself look for in a life partner, or just in any kind of relationship as it is, but, you know, different strokes for different folks, I guess. Alright, we are starting work in an hour, that's right, because we start at 5. I must admit, having a a welcome to the neighbourhood party in the middle of the afternoon is a touch odd. Alright, let's turn this off for starters, and let's maybe grab, oh, what is that? Is that cake that they brought me? Oh, that was nice. I'll try and pull up Emery's mood a little bit. Oh, yeah. That fruitcake just made him uncomfortable. Not good. Okay, so this is part of the add-on pack that I saw, which was quite interesting. Different festivals. Humor and Hijinks Festival. Well, it sounds kind of cool, but we do not have time. We're already running late for work. Emre, you look terrible. There's no way to start your first day in your new career path. We've just left Catherine there by herself. Obviously very trusting. She could rob us blind. Now that we've got much, we've got this sort of half-eaten pizza, which is probably going to go off very quickly, knowing this game. We've got some fruitcake. She can have that, because obviously Emery just doesn't care for it whatsoever. But she may also take our boombox. No, she is just going to read some more. Alright, let's take a quick look at the relationships. So it's Jasminda. We know that her spouse is Aaron, who was with us before. Gita. Unclear if I was going to say if she's in a relationship with Raj, but I'm guessing not, because he is a young adult, she is an elder. And again, no idea who these people are. But maybe we'll have them around to try and build some bridges. Oh, poor Emery. He just looks so dejected. And there goes Catherine. She's just left. Presumably, the apartment is unlocked. And just there for anyone to just wander in at their leisure. Still feeling tense. I'm going to guess that we are not going to be making too much progress in terms of career advancement. Emery swiped an object while he was at work. Obviously, because he's a klepto. Brought home $63, and that was his first day of work. And he is back just gone past 12 o'clock, midnight. So, if this pizza is still good, which it is not, it is spoiled. So we're going to throw that out. We are going to clean that up as well. Because Catherine may be a slob, but Emre certainly is not. And we are gonna... Surely we cannot burn ourselves with a microwave quick meal, right? So let's have some chicken nuggies. And then what else? Fun. I think energy is more important right now. Let's get something to eat. Let's get some rest. And then we can think about having a little bit of fun in the morning. So let's just do the time jump. I'll just go through some of these chores. What's kind of interesting is you can see sort of speech bubbles appearing underneath So presumably that's conversations from people in the apartments below us. Speaking of conversations, I don't know if you picked that up, but the cat is meowing, and I have no idea why. She's being fed. So, that shouldn't be it. Unless she just wants pettings. It's probably that she wants pettings. I don't know if she's had any for a while. I certainly haven't had any with her today. I haven't had a chance. So maybe that's what it is. Maybe it's just the cat's call for pettings. So what we're going to do is I am going to get Emre to bed. He looks like a right state, and we're going to have him sleep. And then I am going to call it a night on this video. It's going to be just a little short one, just to sort of test the waters, see if you guys want to see any more. Where we go from here. Oh, he is now very uncomfortable. I feel like with Emre, we have quite the uphill battle on our hands. He looks like he could be quite the handful. Which, you know, coupled with his career choice, could make for some pretty interesting drama. So yeah, if you guys want to see more, then please do let me know. I am quite happy to do more of these and kind of intersperse them on the reg, as the kids say, because it is fun, and I think we have quite an interesting setup, an interesting character here, and I want to see kind of how far we can get in the criminal career, and I also want to see if this place really is haunted. Anyway, I'm going to leave it there. I'm going to go get the cats and paddings, and yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this, or at the very least, you've managed to fall asleep. In which case, if you have, I hope you have.